Mexican got here just in the nick of time. What does that make us?
Big damn heroes, sir.
Ain't we just?
Don't laugh.
I did not laugh. I'm laughing now.
We're going to be doing the next segment, which is talking about our top five favorite, and this time it's going to be top five favorite films that are going to come out in 2018. So we have three more months left to go.
Yeah.
Each of us will go around the room. So, Katrina, this is the first time you're doing this. What you do is you pick your number five and your number four. You tell us what that is. Tell us a little bit about it. Then David will do his. Then I'll do mine. Then we'll do number three. Three and two, and then one, and so on. So what is your number five and what is your number four top five favorite movie to come out in 2018?
Okay, so I wish I could start from 3, 2, 1, but okay.
No,
5, 4, 2.
We're going all the way down.
So from the bottom, yeah?
Yeah.
So I would say on the bottom of the list is the Bohemian Rhapsody.
Bohemian Rhapsody, yep.
And Aquaman.
And Aquaman. So number five, four is Aquaman. So Bohemian Rhapsody, I can't remember his name, but the guy from... Oh, man, my brain is just... names. He's Mr. Robot. He's in a show called Mr. Robot. It's Sam. No, not Sam. I can't remember his name. But David is gonna get the name for us. Mm-hmm. But the actor who he's in a show on Amazon called Mr. Robot, and he's playing the front runner, the front man of Queen, which is David. Well, who's the front man of Queen? Toby Corns is gonna punch me in the face because Toby Corns is a friend of mine who introduced me to Queen.
Okay.
And everyone is yelling what the name of the who's the lead singer of Queen? Dude, I'm looking at you.
Oh, you're looking at me.
Yes, I'm looking at you. Who's the lead singer of Queen? Because my brain is... I got to...
Freddie Mercury.
Freddie Mercury, thank you. Oh, my... Toby, I'm sorry. I forgot.
He's going to be played by Rami Malek.
Rami Malek, yes. He's from Mr. Robot, which is an Amazon great show. Check it out. If you're into computers and whatnot, check it out. He's playing Freddie Mercury, and from the early clips of it, he is spitting image of the guy.
The trailer looks good.
Yeah, it was supposed to be directed by, was it J.J. Abrams? Or not J.J. Abrams, Bryan Singer. Bryan Singer was supposed to be directing it, but he dropped out. And the guy who was in Snatch and also the film back in the Alan Parker film where they're all shooting each other with pies and Tommy guns. Bugsy Malone.
Yeah,
and he's Babyface. I'm terrible with names. I'll give you a whole bunch of film descriptions, but I can't remember people's names.
You can just describe them and people can guess.
Exactly. Jason, tell me what it... No, I'm sorry. Anyway, he stepped in and he took over. So I'm looking forward to Bohemian Rhapsody. It's not in my top five,
though.
Looked
epic.
Yeah.
I would see it because, you know, it's going to be definitely good film score.
Sure. And music, the music will be great.
It's all about
music. Aquaman. I mean, come on. Jason Momoa, right?
Yeah. I mean, of course, he's a great actor. So
Of course.
I can't imagine if he's going to have a tail, you know, like, how is that going to work?
No, Aquaman is not going to have a tail.
As soon as you say Aquaman, I wrote to somebody with a tail, you know, like a mermaid or something. Male mermaid.
Every comic book fan just went, what?
I haven't seen that one, no.
Sure, it's just because of Jason Momoa.
Yeah, it's just Aquaman and, you know, male mermaid.
it's got Jason Momoa in it, it's got Patrick Wilson in it, it's got Amber Heard in it, it's got Nicole Kidman as well in it. It's gonna be massive. It's DC trying to be good again. So let's go to you for your number three and number two.
Three and two would be Halloween and Robin Hood.
Halloween and Robin Hood. So Halloween, Jamie Lee Curtis comes back. The character Mike Myers comes back. This may, they say it's going to be the last one. It's not. It's just going to be a sequel. This will be very successful. They'll do another one and so on. So, but a lot of people are raving about it. So, hey, who knows?
I love horror movies. Gets old.
And Robin Hood. You're looking forward to Robin Hood?
Robin Hood too, because I like the historical adventure.
Sure.
And I think it's going to be love story, maybe the same concept.
Well, it's going to be, the way I look at it, it's got Taron Egerton as Robin Hood. It's got Jamie Foxx in it, who's going to be reprising I can't remember the name of the character, but he's going to be sort of like the equivalent to Morgan Freeman from the Kevin Costner version in the 90s. So that's pretty much the kind of thing that it's going to be. Mm. And Ben Mendelsohn, he's amazing as a bad guy. So he's going to be in it as well.
I like Robin Hood stories because it reminds me of our national hero, Janosik, in Slovakia.
Okay.
So, and that's I'm writing one script that is inspired by our Slovak national hero, but in English, and it's going to English movie. But inspired something similar to Robin Hood, but Janosik, I don't know if Robin Hood was real. So the Slovak one was actually was a real person.
Yeah, sure.
So something inspired but really nice historical adventure action.
Katrina, what's your number one?
Number one, Predator.
Yes, the Predators. Yes. Shane Black comes back and he's rejuvenating the series with Sterling K. Brown, Olivia Munn, and a whole bunch of other people. That is my number one as
well. That's my number one.
Yeah.